And welcome back to the channel. Today you can join me in Ilfracombe, which is a lovely seaside port in North Devon. So please join me as we look around the sights and sounds of Ilfracombe. There's something for everybody in this picturesque historic harbour of quaint pastel coloured houses, 14th century chapel perched on Lantern Hill, and Damien Hirst statue Verity, standing guard at the entrance, surrounding the dramatic clifftop scenery, and it's directly on the southwest coast path. With its stunning beaches and coves, including famous tunnels, beaches, great eateries, numerous art and craft galleries, independent shops, activities and attractions galore, it truly is a perfect destination from which to also explore North Devon and Exmoor. The statue depicts a pregnant woman holding aloft a sword while carrying the scales of justice and standing on a pile of law books. Half the sculpture shows the internal anatomy of a pregnant woman, with the fetus clearly visible. The stance has been described as a reference to The Little Dancer of 14 Years by Edgar Degas, AC 1880 work, and previously inspired Hirst when he created Virgin Mother, another massive sculpture of a pregnant woman with her fetus exposed. Verity is a 2012 stainless steel and bronze statue created by Damien Hirst. The 20 to 25 metre tall sculpture stands on the pier at the entrance of the harbour in Ilfracombe, Devon, looking out over the Bristol Channel towards South Wales. It has been loaned to the town for 20 years. The sculpture was cast in stainless steel and bronze in over 40 sections. The sword, which gives the statue much of its height, and the upper left arm is one fibreglass piece, measuring 25 centimetres or 10 inches higher than the Angel of the North. Verity became the tallest statue in the UK when it was put into place, but has now been surpassed by a statue in Falkirk, Scotland, at 30 metres 98 feet. Members of the North Devon Council refer to the controversial nature of the statue as a potential boost to tourism. In August 2013, councillors announced the statue had a tremendous effect, with people visiting the town solely to see Hirst's work. Hirst, who lives in Combe Martin, has loaned the statue to the town for 20 years, starting from its erection on the 16th of October 2012.
Like you can take a walk over there, actually, up the mountainside. Not sure how you get to it, but we'll leave that for another day. Just another final look at the statue before we move on to the harbour town itself.
the seafront, why not stroll along the promenade to discover the delights of Ilfracombe seafront? There's always plenty going on, especially during the summer months. There are gift shops, cafes, tea rooms, restaurant pubs and takeaways, everything you need for a proper British seaside holiday. The Landmark Theatre is a striking building. It houses the Tourist Information Centre, and next door you will find Ilfracombe Museum with its weird and wonderful curiosities. Many of the buildings in the town centre date from the 19th century, and it remains refreshingly free of chains that make other towns exactly like anywhere else. Most of the shops are independent retailers, and some have been in the family business for generations. You will find food retailers, banks and building societies, chemists, clothes, homeware shops that will cater for your retail needs. It's often been said that you can find anything you need in Ilfracombe, just not all the same shops. You will also find a warm welcome and an old-fashioned charm rarely experienced these days. No faceless shopping malls.
This is the Inner Harbour. Leading up there from the harbour to the main town area. A lot of it won't be open yet until the Easter break.
Oh my God!
go this side of the harbour, you've got RNLI. Some apartments and hotels. Up on the hillside. And that's obviously where you can take a walk there to the, I suppose, Jurassic Beach, etc. So that's closed at the moment, but I'm sure it'll be open in the near future. So, thank you for joining me as we took a look around Ilfracombe today. Hope you enjoyed it, maybe inspired you to come and visit next time you're in North Devon. It's a lovely place, and hope you visit many more times. Thanks for joining me again. Please join me on the next video as Wandering Spirit. Have a nice afternoon. Goodbye.